Hi everybody, it's time for Within Temptation TV update number 2. A lot has happened since the last update, so let's start right away. Last Wednesday we revealed the first song of our upcoming album, The Unforgiving. Of course we are very excited about the launch of this track, Where is the Edge, because it's the first thing you guys heard of our new album. But one thing I can reveal already about the new album is that no song is going to be alike, style-wise. We've never written so many different songs in one style and put it on one album. So don't expect more of the same thing. Along with the launch of Where is the Edge, fans registered on Facebook and have the unique opportunity to secure a personal credit in a special edition of the new album. Do you want to know more about this? Go to our Facebook page and click on Unforgiving plugin. The new song has been launched, featuring exclusive preview scenes of the upcoming movie Me and Mr. Jones. The movie is a thriller inspired by the disappearance of Natalie Holloway on Aruba. Though this song was not written for the movie, but based on the story of the Unforgiving comic novel, there is definitely a strong link between the both stories. Paul Ruven, the director of Me and Mr. Jones. He is going to tell us more about the movie, and there's definitely a lot he can tell about that. So here we are at the office of Paul Ruven, the director of Me and Mr. Jones, and we're gonna do an interview with him right now. Thanks for doing this interview. Maybe it's good if you first introduce yourself.
Yes, I'm a Dutch filmmaker. I made like 20 or 30 movies, some small ones, some larger ones. Half of them are in English.
So when did you realize that you wanted to be a film director?
Yes, well, my first passion was becoming someone like you. The guitar player or the singer of a rock band. That was my biggest passion. And then I noticed, well, everybody else noticed that I don't have any feeling of rhythm, so everybody said don't do it. And my second biggest passion was movies.
Now, when did you come up with the idea to make this movie?
Well, the thing was, I was living in Los Angeles at the time that Natalie Holloway was disappeared. And then the name Jeroen van der Sloot, the Dutch guy Jeroen van der Sloot, came up. And it was on the news in Hollywood every day. And because we are Dutch, everybody said, everybody started blaming us. How can you Dutch guys let this Jeroen van der Sloot go? And what is this crazy Aruba? Well, we were intrigued because we didn't know Aruba also. So we went to Aruba and we found out that it's a very, you can't really understand in the beginning how the culture is, because it's very difficult. There are Dutch neo-colonials, there are Americans. It's also strange that for Dutch people, we have to use our passport to get in Dutch Aruba, but Americans just can go in with nothing, with a driver's license. So it was strange, and there was a mystery. And many people told us many different solutions to what happened to Natalie. The movie Me and Mr. Jones is about an undercover journalist who wants to find out what happened with Natalie Holloway, who disappeared 5 years ago on Aruba, on Dutch Aruba. You can't film in Aruba because they hate Natalie Holloway journalists, because it's bad for the economy. He hires an escort girl, played by Hannah Verboom, and pretends he's just, they are a young couple in love, so they can come close to all the places where they want to find clues of where Natalie should be. What the undercover journalist wants to do is to break in Jeroen van der Sloot's home to find new evidence, because Jeroen van der Sloot told lies to everybody in the world for 5 years of what he has done with Natalie Holloway. And that's the start of a thriller. First of all, I want to entertain people, and on the other hand, I want to show people some other aspects of the case that you never saw before, and some thoughts of how it was, and to give some insight in the culture also.
I heard this movie was not easy to shoot, and you had to be a bit secret about it. How come?
One example is that we wanted to shoot on the beach where Duran and Natalie were last seen. On that beach you can never film. Never, 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 ever. So, but we had one chance. And the chance was that the Dutch soccer team played on the World Championship against Denmark. And it was in 7 in the morning in Aruba. So while the whole island was watching the television, we went there on the island, on that beach. It was the only chance we had. So it was very exciting. It was almost like you did a bank robbery thing.
How was it also for the actors to be in this movie?
There were actors, but we used actors from another island, from Curaçao.
Oh, really?
They yes, Curaçao. Yes. We flew them in, and they did their thing, and they went away. But it's not that we wanted to do this, but we were forced to do this more or less because of the situation, because everybody was crazy. You can't have a secret on this island because everybody knows everybody. So we had to be, we had to share a little secret with each other. And also they helped us because then somebody walked by and he saw that he wanted to warn people. And then Hannah said something like, oh, but we're doing a swimsuit shot, because she was wearing a swimsuit. And everybody just did, yeah, we were doing the swimsuit, and she did the swimsuit. So this guy thought, okay, so maybe they're not filming, they just do a swimsuit ad. And so he went on, and then we started doing the scene again, which was very exciting. But it's even more exciting because we have this beautiful song Lost of Within Temptation and this beautiful song Where. Because if you make a movie about this, you think of a score, and the score is it has to be it has tension and it has love story, etc. But you always want to have two great songs which help the movie, which make the movie. Because it's such a great song, but it's like you wrote it after you saw the movie. People will not believe it. I can't tell exactly what it is because then I tell some of the plot of the story. But some of the plot of the story is in that song. And it is a beautiful song.
Yeah, it's bizarre.
Yeah, it's bizarre.
It was written, you know, before we knew it was going to be in a movie. So yeah. It's actually about the story of the comic. But we ourselves, when we saw it, it's meant to be almost.
Yes. Yeah. So it was unbelievable.
Do you also think that you're going to make a sequel to this movie?
In February, I believe that they are reopening the case in Aruba. If there's enough material which inspires me, I really would like to do some sort of sequel. Absolutely. I just hope that people enjoy this movie because it's very entertaining and because the song Lost is so beautifully in it. Yeah, and we're very, very, very honored that we were allowed and that you helped us so much and that you were so fantastic. It's very rare in music world that this happened.
Well,
it's true.
Honor is mutual, so
okay.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Hopefully okay. Till the next.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay.
In the first update, I've told you about your news and how you can upload your own news on the website. It's really fun for us to see how much articles you guys have posted. Keep on uploading your news so we can make a network of Within Temptation journalists around the world. We started to work with the first official Within Temptation reporters, but we'll tell you more about these reporters in the next update. If you still want to become an official Within Temptation reporter, please check the website. A good example of your news is the article that Greek23WT posted about What Have You Done, which was chosen and performed in the Greek version of a TV show called Just the Two of Us. Greek singer Isaias and Greek actress Mariana made a bold attempt by performing What Have You Done. Okay, maybe it's not the best performance, but of course this TV show is all about entertainment. And to me personally, it was really entertaining. And also respect to them for doing something which is clearly not something they do every day. I know I'd shit my pants. So thanks again, Greek23WT, and keep us updated about the news in Greece. Once in a while, WTTV recommended posts a video you don't want to miss. This week, I wanted to highlight the video of a Harry Potter fan. If you haven't seen it, here's a short fragment.
Where is that bloody camera? Oh, there it is. Wingardium Leviosa. Hello, I'm Harry Potter himself. You're looking for America's biggest Harry Potter fan, but you're in luck. You found the world's biggest Harry Potter fan. I can wear Harry Potter clothing every day for 3 months without wearing the same thing twice. And in 2006, I went and saw J.K. Rowling in New York City. I'll see your book. Where she signed this. And this, which is now one of 4 tattoos on my body, with plans for more. So, I have this challenge to issue. You might think you're the biggest fan, you might think you know the biggest fan, but I promise you, you are mistaken. I'm Harry Potter himself, and I leave you with this. Finite incantatum.
Now this makes me wonder, are you the biggest Within Temptation fan, or maybe a fanatic fan of something totally different? Show us in a video and upload it on your news. I'm really looking forward to see your collections out there. WTTV was also at the launch of the new Call of Duty game. Don't know if you know the game, but it's mainly about shooting and killing other people. So not for the faint of hearts. However, we were invited to the release party of this new game. And since Daniel, our producer, is a huge Call of Duty fan, we decided to join him there.
Good evening, Europe. My name is Mark Wami and I'm the studio head at Treyarch. On behalf of everyone on the Call of Duty Black Ops team, I want to extend a very special thank you for everyone for attending the worldwide launch of Call of Duty Black Ops.
Well, the best thing about the evening were definitely the drinks. They were free. For the rest, I just heard a lot of noise. There's a lot of shooting, but I wasn't able to play it myself, so that was kind of boring. A lot of guys, no chicks, hardly any chicks. So boring.
I think it's really cool tonight. It's nice atmosphere, but the game is a little bit violent. I just stood downstairs watching promotion stuff and the real action playing stuff. But it's a lot of dead people in 1 minute.
My name is Joost and I'm here with Martijn because we're starting to get into a little bit of the game music. It's cool. I mean, this is totally new for me. I've never been to such a release party. I only been to release parties of bands, you know. But this is, for me, it's a new thing. I'm not a big gamer myself.
I like the game, I play the game. But, I don't know, I'll have to try it. This is where I am. Looks great. I don't know what to say about the game. I do play this game, but I'm not a gamer. I don't like games in general. I'm not sitting in front of a computer always. But to brainwash myself, sometimes I play this game. So that's the reason I'm here today.
I just have a very old game computer from 1986 with Pac-Man on it. That's the only one I have. I'm really not a game guy. My hobbies are just music. I don't have any other hobbies.
I do like games. You know, I like this Call of Duty. I like it a lot. I am though of course a much bigger race game fan, but now and then I really like to shoot some people.
Yes, we're playing again on Mira Luna. This festival for sure has a special place in our hearts. The first time we ever played on a real goth festival in Germany was there, and we liked it straight away. It's one of those festivals where it's just great to be, because next to the music there are so many interesting things, interesting looking people, and still there's a completely relaxed and friendly atmosphere. It's also definitely one of the darkest sounding and looking festivals around, but also with the nicest people, and that's our favorite combination. Now, recently a trailer was released for a new American TV series called The Borgias. In this trailer, a part of our song Jillian was used. Now, I don't know if you guys know, but Jillian was released on the Silent Force album in 2005. An original Jillian is one of the main female characters in a series of books by Catherine Kerr called the epic The Very series. Anyway, The Borgias will be aired in 2011. When and where? When we hear it, we'll let you know. Then news about Root. Last show we mentioned that Root made an acoustic Iron Maiden tribute album called Maiden United. Currently they are touring and performing these songs live. So for pics, reports and new dates, check their site. Now the next update will probably be online after Christmas. So on behalf of the whole band, a Merry Christmas to all of you.